Generic greetings, we're back on Scrap Mechanic once again for a little bit of a mess around. This is a vehicle that apparently rolls over at the drop of a hat. It's the thing we made in the preview video, and I'm just gonna get rid of that, and then we can drive around, as you can clearly see. And it's made of concrete, which is why it's very, very heavy. We can press one button and that will open these engine things, and then we can press another button and that activates thrusters, which we can then blast off here. And yeah, very, very nice. But it is, it's got a lot of weight at the front there, although this guy is, you know, probably part of that. Let's just fold that back up and there we go. Sweet. Yeah, so I have an idea to make something that is I think the inspiration comes from the DeLorean in Back to the Future, where the wheels sort of fold underneath. I want to make a vehicle where the wheels fold underneath and some sort of jet engines then fold out from the side and then allow us to fly, but I have no idea how I'm going to build it. So let's just have a crack on. So we're going to place a lift, raise it up a little bit, and then we're going to place some sort of wooden base. So we'll make it, I think that's six. One, two, three, four, five. No, it's not six. We'll make it one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, five, six. There we go. I still think that one, two, three, four, five, six. It would be nice to have some sort of measuring system in it. And then what I want to do is have it at least another three wider either side. So we'll bring it over here and then there we go. That's the base that we're going to have the vehicle on. It's not that much bigger from that. No, I think it's probably about the same, if not a little bit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 3, 6, 7, 8. It'll be, yeah, that'll be right. Okay. Oh, by the way, I've got a beverage here with me as well, naturally. That's nice. That's a ruby breakfast. It's pretty much orange and grapefruit mixed together with everything else they had in the bottom of the vats at the time at the factory. I think the idea for a ruby breakfast was someone went, hey, you know all that sludge we've got in the bottom of the vats that we just can't sell because it's a bit, you know, bad quality and all that, and we don't really have enough to make viable amounts of it? Yeah, well, why don't we mix it all together? Uh-huh. And we'll call it something really fancy like a ruby breakfast, and then people will think it's, like, a lot more than what it is, and we'll sell it for millions. And they went, yeah, promote that guy. Anyway, so this is our base. What I'm going to do is cut off either side. Now, I've had no real, like I say, I have the overall idea of what I want to make, a vehicle where the wheels fold down, but I don't know how I'm going to do it. Either way, let's see what we can do. That's going to be our base. Hang on. So what happens now? Well, this is where we're going to have, well, we could have some sort of system where it goes down. What if we have, I'm trying to think of a way to make these wheels go down. If I had them like that and then put something there, we could then make it go in and then further. Okay, let's have a go at this one. Let's put a bearing on this. So we'll cut one, two. We don't need to cut that much out, actually. Let me just get rid of that. Put it back. There we go. We're going to put a bearing on either side there. And then we want to cut out them two, put one back in, cut out that one and put that one back in, and then we'll put them in there like so. Right, and then what we'll do, we'll go down by two. Hang on, we'll say, rotate that down, and down by two like that, and then down by two like that, and actually, we'll make it go down by three. We'll rise it up just a little bit, and then we'll make it go down by three like that, on either side, on each corner. There we go. And then we can have probably the wheels on this, and then they can fold in by 45 degrees. No, that's not going to work. That's not going to work. What we need to do is really have it even further down like that. But how are we going to rotate this? That's the question. What I'm going to do is get rid of these ones like so, and then I'm going to put a bearing on the bottom of that one, on the bottom of that one, and then I'm going to bring that down one, two, and then one, and then two. And then, as I said, that's going to be our steering, but we do need to make it a little bit more foldy-innery. That's a word now. And how we're going to do that, I think bearing, and then bearing, and then bearing, and then another down by two. One, two, and then again one, two, and then this one, one, two, and then again one, and then two, and then what I'm going to do is place a controller, because this is already getting a little bit over the top. So what I'm going to do is just place actually some sort of seating arrangement, because that would be good. Let me see if I can get on top of here. There we go. And we'll place a seat. We're going to call it about there, I think. There we are. Then we need some sort of engine. So what I'll do is I'll place the engine on first, because obviously I know where it's going to go. Then we'll place the controller on the back like that. Okay. In fact, well, I'm going to get rid of said controller and place it a little bit more central, because then I'll be able to control it a little bit easier. Why is it not going on the right way? That's really weird. Rotate the right way, would you? Yeah, that's where it's going to go. Right, so, connections. Okay, this looks complicated already. So, that one goes to that seat. That one goes to that seat, right? So that's the steering. Oh, God, look at that one. That's just like, hey, I've got stuff as well. Let me just get in here and drive it over there so I don't... I can't see. Oh, no, you can see it from pretty much any distance. Right, so there's the steering connector rated up. And you connect that to that, and there we are. And then we need to make sure these are connected to the controller. So we're going to have stage one. So one, two... And can we disconnect that one? Yeah, one, two, three, and then four. I don't know why these are different from that one. That is weird. And then five. Actually, no. Get rid of them ones because we want to say one, two, three. I've done it in a weird way. One and two at the front, left and right. And then it's going to be three and then four. And then it's going to be five, six, seven, eight. Now we know a rough idea of that one. So what is the positive on this? So the positive is blue. So that is that, and that is, that one needs to rotate. This one should rotate. No, actually, no, it shouldn't rotate because remember that's on the other side. So positive will go out. Yeah, so that one's to go in. So this one, positive will go that way. So that one's to rotate. So that'll go inwards. Positive will make that one go inwards. That one is positive goes that way. For some reason, they rotate them in some weird ways. I don't know why. Positive will go that way, that's correct. Positive will go that way, that's correct. And positive will go that way. That is okay. Right, so we're going to raise that up, and then we're going to put some more bearings on this. So one, and then two, three, and then five. Right, and then what we want to do is place some wheels. We're going to place some big chunky wheels, because I've never used these, and also I selected the wrong wheel, so it doesn't matter. And then we need to connect these up to the motor. So I believe it's one, and then two, three, and then four. That should do it. So let's just try something first. Let me just remove this and hopefully it won't break. No, that stays there, so we can get on that. Actually, no, what we want to do is jump up first, and we need to activate that and make sure that it's got a little bit of power. Get on this thing, close that gas engine down, get on that, and then we can... It does turn, but not in the directions we want, because I've not put it in the right way. So that's forward will be that way, forward will be that way, forward will be that way, forward will be that way. So that's now correct. And the steering bearings need to change. So that and then that. I think that one changed. We'll see in a moment. And left and right. And this does actually function. Right, okay. So it's got no suspension, but it is there. So that is fine. That does indeed work. Now, big question. Now I need to alter the controller. So we'll put it back on the lift like so. And then we'll rise it up just a little bit. And then I'll have a sip of beverage. Oh, I don't care if it's all the bits from the factory, it's quite tasty. Right, so let's alter the controller. So the controller, we need, on the first step, we want everything to go 45 like this. And then that'll go in by at least 45 for each of the first four stages. And then the second stage, we could say 45 for that one. Or if we really wanted to, now that I think about it, we could say 45 for all of them and then they would all go in. Let's try that one, shall we? Now, I don't know what's going to happen here. Now, if I've worked this out correctly, which I almost certainly won't have done, what's going to happen is when I press the button, this button here that I haven't yet placed, it will activate the controller. All of these side ones will go in and the wheels will end up right underneath next to each other. So here we go. Have I done it correctly? Oh, yeah. Okay, let's undo that. Right, so it does happily fold in, but slight problem, the wheels are too big, which is why I originally planned out the smaller wheels. I just didn't put them on correctly. So let me just get rid of these. It doesn't really matter. It won't change a lot of things, but there we go. Well, I would say it won't change a lot of things. I won't have to redesign it. So here we go. And then try that again. That is sort of what I was looking for. That goes in by 45. That goes in by 45. And it sits quite happily. nice and squat. I'm really happy with that, actually. So let's just open that up, and then we will connect up the seat to that button at the back, which is button number one. So if we can happily drive along, and then it doesn't really steer at all because the wheels are too small, and obviously we don't have any suspension. What I could do is change the back wheels to be steering as well. That'll probably give it a little bit of a helping hand. But yeah, I think we're going to have to do that, but it means a lot of messing around. So we'll see. I might leave it because we've still got the jet engines to do yet. And then if I just go brake system activated... it still works. And in fact, we sort of waddle back and forward there. Then we activate the wheels again and we do that. Now, I have actually seen a design, which is very, very clever, where someone made a set of rails. Right, a nice set of rails all the way along, like along a mountaintop like that. It looked like, oh, bloody hell, God, we did an endo there. Didn't know we could do that. Endo! Was that an ollie? No, an ollie's the other way around, isn't it? Yeah, endo is endover. Yeah, there we go. Look at the braking system on that. Yeah, come on. Yeah. Yeah, look. Yeah, so they made like a monorail system, and you could go up to it and then like clamp your wheels on like that to the rail and then go forward, because the wheels are still going forward, as you can see. And actually, you probably can't see because of the grass, but they are actually pulling forward together. But either way, I'm very happy with how that came out. It's a little bit top heavy, but that's okay. So we'll just stop that, and then we'll get off it. Right, so that does actually function, which is good. So we're going to place that on the lift and then drag it back up. So now what we need to do is have some way of controlling the... Well, we've got that, so it does function. So let's press the button there. Oh, I don't know why you can't activate that when it's there. Because what I'm going to have to do now is work out how to put the engines on when they're closed and then activate them so they go on the side. And, oh, God. There's just a little bit of the game that's a bit more annoying than it needs to be, because so that's where it's going to sit. If it sits happily there, yeah, it's going to sit happily there. It's nice and squat. Right, so that's the sitting down bit of it. What I need to do now is have, and that's, I can't really have much more in terms of controllers on that, because the controller can only have a total of 10 bearings on it. So what I'm going to have to do is have just two others for the jet engines. So the jet engines will happily sit 1, 2, 3. Hang on. There we go. And then we'll put up from there. Rotate that up. 3, 3, and 3. All right. And then what we'll do, we'll place the engines... How are we going to do this? Along the side. Yes. Bearing. Over here. Ah, as I said, problem. The bearing system. We can only have a total of 10 connected to that controller. So it means we're going to have to have another controller, which is a little bit annoying, but we can handle it. At least then we'll be able to control both separately. So every cloud and all that. Then this goes on to... No, this is why I needed, ideally, the lift back on. So we'll put the lift on there. There we go. So then we need to have these going either side like so. Like that, right? Then. Yeah, I thought that might happen. I can't connect them up to each other. But I think I can. I just need to... And jump on the top and work out, is it just a case of doing it from there? It is. Right, so what I'll do, I'll get rid of them. Right, so that is the jet engine storage solution system. And then I need to cut... Oh, yes, that's right. It doesn't connect at that end, does it? All right, okay. So what I'm going to have to do is pretty much redesign that. Hang on, then. Hang on, Derek. Oh, God. Right. This is a little more complicated than it needs to be. Right, get rid of that. Get rid of all these up to the end there. Right. At least it's similar to all these objects physically. Right, so these are on this side, so they're going to go there. I need them to all go to that side, which means we want... That there, and then that there. need them to come out by 3. I think that is correct. Actually, let's make it 2. By 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. And then bearing, like so, either side. Then 1, 2. Like that. And then bearing, and then that down to there. No, because the whole thing's going to rotate outwards, isn't it? So we can't really have that. I'm trying to do this without 57,000 bearings. That should do. Let's have a mess around. We can always, you know, tweak the design later on. So let's put this into here. Jet engine 1, 2, and then 3, 4, right? That is really, really tall. So we need another controller, which I'm going to place on the front this time. So at least we've separated the two off. So we'll place it on here. Hang on. Jump up. There's one unit of that. Place a button, because we'll need one. And then we'll get our... Oh, God, it's really complicated. Right, so... That engine can go to a button, which I'll place here. So that button will actually activate them ones. 1, 2, 3, and then 4. All right, so that's the jet engine activation system. And then these bearings, we're going to do the same as before. So it'll be 1, 2, 3, and then... 4. Right, and so what is positive? Positive is that way, that is good. Positive that way, positive that way, positive that way. And not that way, that way, that way, and that way. Okay, and then back to the controller. Controller is 1. Because remember, I'm trying to do that corner first. Well, it's actually 5, 6, and then 7 and 8. So positive. Let's go back. It's easier to work from this. So remember, blue's positive. So that wants to go positive that way. Because we're rolling it over that way. Anti-clockwise. Positive that way. Positive that way. Yes, and positive for 7. I think I've got them slightly wrong. But either way, 7 is that way. Right, so... There's that fine. What we're going to do then is connect up this to the button and then the button to the center. And that's our button to the center for the activation of the jets. Then we need to go to the controller. And then again, everything needs to go at 45 like so. And if I've got this correct, then what will happen is when I activate it, it should all work fine. What are the chances of that? Well, it's not the nicest looking vehicle ever, and it's got no control when it's in the air. But obviously what I can do if I wanted is place pretty much a boatload of bearings on one of these sections, and then we can alter this. I know it's in development, but I guess this is a perfect time to say it and stuff. You know, I really want some sort of... like just a gimbal, so you know, because the bearings are, you know, rotation one way or the other. You know, they're not like a ball joint. A ball joint or a controllable ball joint would be much better. Also, pistons would be good. Right, let's just get on this thing. Actually, no, we're not. We're gonna back up to the front here and back up to the front. We're gonna go to the front of the back with the back, and we're gonna press this button. Right, that activates all engines. Good. Now this one should make them rotate the row. Yeah. They don't go far enough out. So what I'll do, this is a very, very hacky solution, but it's the only solution I really can stomach, because otherwise it would take a lot more work to get this fixed. I mean, you can just sit for hours messing around in this game. Ooh! It still hits. Where's the problem? The problem is that the first four should go 90. And actually, now that one thinks of it, these don't really need to turn at all. The original idea was to have them all turn 45, but because I didn't lengthen, I only lengthened that out by one because I thought it was getting too tall, it wasn't going to work. So that goes to there, which puts them exactly where they need to be. And folds them in roughly right. Let's just try this. Oh god, this thing. Right, so we can drive along. We can easily roll over, I'm guessing. No, it's actually because it's made it heavier, it's made it a lot more stable. And then at any point, we can just turn the wheels off. We can activate jet engines. And then take... Ooh, good... Why do all my vehicles end up upside down? Right, so... That does... indeed function. I mean, ish. Very, very ish. Let's... What we need to do is weigh it down. Why was it going like that at the back? I'm guessing because it weighs too much. Well, it weighs too much at the front. So what I'm going to do is get a concrete block. And then we're going to place one, two, and then like that, right? So that should ballast this out. Oh, I need to get rid of the lift. Make sure you remove the lift. Well, thank you very much for that. So. Oh, that glitches out. Oh, yeah. You know what? I think the ballast is a little bit wrong, so... Try that again. Activate that. Turn them on. Oh, good grief. Because it's got... It's the center of gravity... the center of gravity is, like, it's really high. You know what I mean? So it's just tipping over. I mean, we could easily fix that by putting some ballast on the bottom. Or changing, like, say, the where the wheels are connected, them little struts there. Actually, we could probably fix this. No, we can't. No. See, it just goes upside down! That's all it does! We can easily change that by putting some concrete as the wheel struts. That would work out. Let me get back on this. What I'm going to do, I've been trying to drive it and activate everything at once, which we don't need to do. I'm going to give it a stand. I'm going to give it a complete stop. Right, so center of gravity, definitely not fixed. Center of balance. Go at the back. Concrete. A little bit better, but still not there. Right, better plan. Get rid of them. Lift. See, this is where everything comes in. You know, you can happily design whatever you want, but it really is the tweaking that really makes a vehicle. Although I think any amount of tweaking is not going to totally fix the problems of this. Again, we're almost there. You can see it's just a little bit off balance. And this is making it heavier, which is actually a good thing. That's as balanced as I'm going to make it, but you can't control it, obviously, because of... Oh, actually, you can. Sorry, you can. And because of the way, for whatever reason, the wheels work, they seem to be able to grab air and give you a bit of traction. So you can see that if I... I'm going to turn them off. And then on, and then... Ooh, crap. Oh, did you see his head come straight out there? His head just flew straight off, pretty much. That works, actually. I'm very surprised. Very surprised that sort of functions. I mean, we could easily... I mean, if there was aerofoils and stuff, you know, flaps and sort of ailerons and anything that was like some sort of wind surface, you know, for lift, that would be good. Then we'd be able to control this thing, but we really can't. We'd have to put more jet engines on it, which, again, is just a hole in the gear, but it is in development. The, you know, the basics are here. So let's just try a standing flight. So we'll come to a stop. We pull the wheels down. We activate that. And then there we go. And we can actually make it go tilt forward. Tilt that way. Tilt that way. It's actually a bit too heavy now. Land on the wheels. And then it goes upside down again. Is it just too heavy at the back? It might be a little bit too ass heavy. It also depends on exactly what ground you are sitting on. Like, if it's only slightly off, that's why I'm driving here, because this looks like quite level. Wheels go down. I think them... Oh, no. No. Them blocks are stopping it, actually. That's something there. Them blocks. That one. And that one. In fact, probably them as well. They're stopping this. So we need to get rid of them. Put some more on the back. Right, that should probably fix it. No, it's still... No, it's because the blocks are underneath, of course. Of course. That's what's probably doing it. Yeah, that's why the whole design's garbage. Yeah, that's why it's obviously not working. Right, let's get rid of them. So we can't really have anything under there because obviously it'll stop the wheel. Right. That falls down. Activates engines. Tilt left, tilt right, tilt forward, tilt back, back, tilt back, tilt back. Activate wheels, 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 wheels. Oh, and we went inside the ground again. Well then, that got stuck in. You know what though? I think that is as close to as like perfect as we're going to get this thing. I mean, what we could do if we really wanted to. What I would do if I was going to do this again, because as I said, this is the first and only attempt of this. I would remove these bottom sections and make them concrete, so it's, you know, it lowers the center of gravity, so it's not going to tip over as much. I would probably make it wider so I can fold these engines in, you know, to pretty much 180 degrees. So one of them would turn 90, the other would turn 90, so they're actually pointing up instead of just out the side here. And that would probably be about it, actually. I'll maybe try to put some suspension on, but I don't really know. Let's have a, instead of going for a standing start, we'll go for like a little bit of a drive. So we would, the idea is we'll be just driving along. God, it doesn't have wheelie because of the thing at the back. So, oh, good grief. We've really wrecked the handling on that one. And then we would just decide to, oh, you know what? Let's just have a bit of a takeoff. So we would say engines and go. And then we would put the wheels down and then. Yeah, it doesn't work that well, does it? No, it's fine. One more attempt, come on, we can pull this off. Reduce the power, go. That's fine, so it doesn't wheelie anymore. Need to jump over our old vehicle, and then there we go. Do you know what the problem is? Because you've got forward motion, I don't know whether it's like, well, it's making it pull back and then backflip, and I don't know whether that's because of the ballast. Let's try it once more. Okay, here we go. Oh, damn it. Oh, what? Oh. That's not good. I think I might have got rid of the wrong bit. Well, the jet engine didn't fall off, so we're okay. That's how they work at Heathrow. As long as the engine didn't fall off, it's safe to fly. Right. Spin it round. It's not wheeling. It's got better handling. He says that. Right, so forward. We need to get over this. Engines, go. There we go. Pull the engines in. Yeah, because the... Because they're colliding with each other, you can hear them going... Then they're... They're sort of banging into each other and causing some issues. You know what, though? I am fairly happy with that. It's a good proof of concept. I think it needs to be wider. At least, say, a block wider either side. And then these wheels would fold in correctly. We need to add it so that these can be controlled. Because you can put them on, like, fins. So you can have, say, like a fin coming out like so. And then you have a bearing on here. You have a bearing and then another like set of two like that, and the bearing would be like on that corner, and then that would be able to turn that way and that way, you see. But then sometimes you can connect it to the seat and it works, and sometimes you can't. You have to connect it to a button and then control it from the bottom. But anyway, that's something we could have done. That's something we could do. We could mess around with it. But I think we're going to leave it there. Not a bad design. It's certainly been fun to make, and that's pretty much what this game is about, making weird, interesting stuff. Doesn't really matter whether it works or not. It's whether you have fun along the way. As you can see, it does actually sort of function. It just, for some reason, always wants to go on its ass, which is, you know, generally a bad thing. Let me just, I'm really, really want to get this heavier in the center. There we go. That should really alter it now. One and two. Yeah, they just collide. Hang on. Hang on. No, that didn't work. There you go, anyway. There is our, whatever you would call that, our weird wheel folding in, or engine popping out, or a vehicle of death that really you would not want to drive. I mean, taxed worse, fair enough, but yeah, there it is. Either way, links in the description, you can check this game out yourself. Thank you very much for watching. Take care, and generic partings. We're going to land on our face again. Yeah, that position's suboptimal, isn't it?